OBS Studio is an incredible piece of software, letting you stream, record, and do all manner of crazy things absolutely free, though you should certainly support it. But there's a lot of settings and options to dive through. Today I wanted to point you towards 7 less talked about OBS settings that you should consider enabling or disabling, I guess, to make your streaming life easier in this video sponsored by Nerd or Die. I'm EposVox, the stream professor, and I have countless videos on my channel talking about OBS and streaming and how to get the most out of your tech. I have a new mini-series coming about explaining what little features in OBS actually do on a more technical level, says there's a lot of misinformation out there about them, so hit that subscribe and notification button so that you can stay informed. I'd consider this video a kind of intermediate guide to OBS, so if you're confused about some of the basics, check out my OBS masterclass to get up to speed, but let's jump in with setting number 1. Automatically start the replay buffer when you stream and the like. If you're unaware, OBS Studio has a neat feature that lets you keep a running recording going, but only save a specific chunk of time in the past, useful for grabbing highlights or making instant replays without having to cut up, you know, a long VOD or anything like that. I have a couple tutorials on how to actually use this and how to do it with some plugins linked below. But unlike NVIDIA Shadow Play, which you can have running basically at all times, OBS's replay buffer doesn't just run as a system process. You have to manually start it. Thankfully, they've added a checkbox in the General Settings tab, which allows the replay buffer to automatically start whenever you hit Start Streaming. This way, you don't have to remember anything but to go live and then hit your Save Replay Buffer hotkey whenever you want to save a clip, and always be ready to rock. And of course, it works on AMD cards or even Intel iGPUs, since it doesn't require NVIDIA GPUs like Shadow Play as well. Likewise, there's a checkbox to automatically start recording when you start streaming. Because I haven't had this checkbox checked, and because I was trying to save on recording space for the start of a stream, every stream I've done for the past 6 months has had me pause about 5 minutes in and say, "Whoops, I forgot to hit start recording." Well, no more! This box makes sure that you have high-quality local VOD always saved, useful for busy people who don't remember everything, like myself. These first few settings have been hiding in the overlooked General Settings tab, options some of us just kind of forget over time, but I'll have some secrets at the end of this video as well. Organizing your sources on the OBS canvas can be pretty tedious, but thankfully in past updates they've added snapping for sources, so you can easily align your sources to the edge of the canvas and to other sources. Unfortunately, not all of the snapping features are enabled by default. In the General Settings again, make sure the source alignment snapping is even enabled in the first place. Here you can adjust the sensitivity for OBS to detect that a snap should happen, as well as toggle edge or other source snapping. The one that's often left unchecked is snap sources to horizontal and vertical center option, which can make things a lot easier for centering and aligning sources, especially bigger ones. If you want better sources for your stream, perhaps an easy to set up high quality layout with webcam frames, segment scenes, alerts, sub and tip labels, and so on, then you have to check out our sponsor, Nerd or Die. Nerd or Die has everything you need for a top tier, high production value stream, and their graphics packs are like no other. The new Boosted Alerts pack helps really just kind of encourage viewers to get a sub or tip train going, and they have full packages to match any style. Mine, yours, your friends, doesn't matter. Plus, each pack comes with an instant setup script for OBS Studio, Streamlabs OBS, and Stream Elements. Check them out today at eposvox.gg/nerdordie and save 15% at checkout with coupon code EposVox, or if you watch this in time, the summer sale, save 20% with summer 20 at checkout as well. Our last setting in the General tab has to do with Studio Mode. Studio Mode splits the OBS preview into a preview and program monitor view. The program monitor is the view currently shown on stream to your viewers, whereas the preview lets you see the next scene that you wish to QE up. This has no end of applications and is how most broadcast tools usually work, but OBS lets you customize it a bit. You can enable and disable labels to specifically identify which preview is which. That helps with space conserving and things like that if you don't need the labels. But the big one is enabling the vertical layout. This puts the two previews on top of each other, which could help you get the exact layout configuration that you want in OBS, especially for those of you running OBS on a vertical monitor. You can enable transitioning by double-clicking on that scene as well, which is a tad more accessible, you know, with a quick action than just clicking on the specific little transition button. If you didn't know, hit Studio Mode under Start and Stop Recording to actually show Studio Mode or hide it entirely. I'll have a whole video on optimizing your OBS layout coming soon, so get subscribed for that one. Let's jump to the Advanced tab now. First and foremost, automatically remux to MP4. You should be recording everything in OBS to a .mkv container to prevent corruption. Masterclass episode link below. But remembering to Remux in order to edit your videos or whatever after the fact can be a pain. With this checkbox, you can be certain that everything you record gets auto-swapped to MP4 as soon as you're done. It doesn't take long, since Remuxing is effectively a file copy between containers, and it is definitely worth doing. Unfortunately, it does not auto-delete the MP4 that is recorded, and that's also a safety measure in case the Remux doesn't work, but you will have to go in and delete the MKV file after it makes the MP4. Second, we have a kind of niche option that maybe not everyone should use, but one that's helpful for some in a pinch: dynamic bitrate changing. This is a new-ish feature that's still technically in beta, but if you have a history of getting bitrate fluctuations or frame drops due to networking issues, be it an unreliable ISP, getting stuck on Wi-Fi, or just random issues you still can't figure out, this checkbox could save your stream. The box attempts to lower your bitrate when OBS detects that your network can't keep up with the bitrate that you're trying to stream, and will then raise it back up when things improve. This means that, yes, your quality will drop during low bitrate moments, that's impossible to avoid here, but your frame rate will be more stable and you run less of a risk of just disconnecting your stream entirely or leaving your viewers buffering waiting on you to show back up. I'd only enable this feature if you know you need it, but it could be very helpful. Also, if you're having networking issues, you could tinker with the enable network optimizations and the enable TCP pacing checkboxes as well and see if they help your issues. Lastly, we have the big render lag fix that I made a huge big deal about when it was first implemented, but still not enough people know about it. If you're running OBS in a single PC streaming setup and you're streaming GPU heavy tasks, so gaming, video editing, 3D work, etc., run OBS as administrator. The Windows team have finally cooperated, although again, this was a couple years ago, but they finally cooperated and allowed OBS to reserve the graphics resources it needs in real time by running it as administrator in Windows 10, helping it compete with everything else, like your games and things like that. This is an absolute must for many games like Apex Legends and Warzone, which will absolutely wreck your graphics performance and cause lots of render lag, even on modest settings and high-end, powerful hardware. If you're getting both encoding and render lag, it's likely that the encoding lag is actually being caused by the render lag. You can't encode frames that were never rendered, after all. So try this fix first before trying to solve the encoding lag. You may find that this fixes that issue as well. It's worth noting that work is being done to phase out the need for the admin fix through the hardware accelerated graphics scheduler option in newer Windows 10 and Windows 11 builds. But so far, it's still a work in progress, and I have found that disabling that and running OBS as admin is still the best or the generally most stable route for now. There's still some work to be done on HAGs. Also, right-click your OBS shortcut, go to Properties, Compatibility, and you can enable a checkbox to always run it as admin so you don't have to manually do it each time. But there you go, a bunch of hidden and less talked about OBS settings that can really help your efficiency and execution of your stream. What else do you want to know about OBS? Join us on Discord at discord.gg/EposVox and let's chat. Remember, be kind, rewind.